like we have from like younger age we play the game of tic-tac-toe. So we know that there are three rows and three columns. So firstly, like in the structure, we can enter any number. Like just enter number 7. Then it's, we can see here 7 appears here. Then enter any number. We have entered number 7, so cross appears out here. Then it was computer's chance. So if they had 0 on the 5th one, enter the next number, any of like 3. We can see here, cross appears here, and then computer chance it goes with 0. Enter 6. So computer gets it 0 here. Then now you can just enter 1 or 3 anywhere. One we appear, so our cross appeared here, and then it was a 0 from computer in the 3rd one. Then just enter the 9. So as we can see out here, the game was gone. So let's see how the we form this game. Let's go to the coding part. We have included the following interface: STDIO, CONIO, STDLIB, and the Windows. You can see here from the Wendy array of size 10, we have taken the elements. When turn is equals to 1, the flag will be 0, and we have two integers, player and computer. Then we have included the following functions, and we can see here that there is a global variable too. Center of axis is set to the top left corner of the screen, and from here, the left corner.
Thank you, Prem. So from here, go to x and y. This is a predefined function. We have predefined function which will set the cursor in x and y. Then we have the void main function where we are calling the menu. So in the menu we have this following things that will show in the slide. Then if the player one chooses one, then we will call the player first function. And in case two, if the computer is one, then it's, we are calling the start main function. If exit, then it will exit, or then it's menu function. In make 2 and make 3, in make 4 we have the, what is, if a board is 5 then it will return 5, if a board is 6 then it will return 6, and thus so. So how, so this is a function where we check whether it's winning and winning or board. So this is a function for row check. So if like if board I, if we say in board I we are giving 1, and it's equals to equals to 2, then it will return 1. If we are given this is 4, so it will return 4 and 5. This will it will check the row. If it's equal, then it will say player wins. So this is the same for column, and this is for diagonal, like 1, 5 and 9, and vice versa, like 3, 5 and 7, and so on. Now I'd like to swastik place it.
So now we talk about the go function which will be called for regularly in this program. Here we are checking if the number of points is given. And if it is given, we input the 3 at code again. Yes, we input 5 at code again. Then we define where first where we initialize a position, and then we declare a call, check now and draw board. And here we take an input from the user for x or o, whatever you want to input. Then we go and check if the board and position is not equal to, and print and declare a player first position. Then we check if the pause at pause speed is equal to player, which means that a player has burst safely. And to in that case, if the player displayed a message on the screen that a player has burst and exit again. And then we define start game, where we are actually symbolizing that the x is equal to O and the O is equal to 0. So that it is just simply easier for the computer to calculate in parallel approach. And here we are defining if the pause period clock is equal to true, and if it is, then we set the flag as 0. Otherwise, we set the flag as 0 and call the increment before. Then we are defining check draw. Here we are checking if the game has been a draw, which means that none has won. We are checking if the number of turns has exceeded the number of turns, which is 9. And then if it is, then we declare that the game has been a draw and exit again. Then we define a draw board which will act as an interface for the user for to interact with the game. we are defining some lines and some dashes for it to look good and to go differentiate between the rows and the columns. And then we are running a loop from 1 to 10 where we are encoding the S and O, where S decided by the user and the controller. Okay. Then we have the last function between both X or O. Here what we are doing is that we are taking an input from the user and encoding it on the board as defined by it. And calculating whether it should be X or O as defined and calculated by our 160 system. And then at last we call code to XY, vector parameters X and O and print the character. Thank you.
Very good.